again, everything's green and new in this week's 10 The Best.
Major design houses and brands are testing the limits of impressions from Chesapeake, using the flexibility of Billerud's fiberform to create shapes and effects that simply are not possible with conventional board. Impressions uses a special low-energy process to form the fiberform material into a complete range of distinctive shapes, with Chesapeake claiming to pioneer a completely new way of shaping board. Chesapeake are developing new technology to make large-scale production of impressions both fast and cost-efficient. Now, we don't have images yet, but we do have news of the new Fishbein Saxon Help to Palletize unit. The Help to Palletize unit is used to pile up automatically bags of 25 to 50 kilograms on a pallet at a maximum speed of 400 to 500 bags per hour, depending on the type of bags, the height of the pallet, and the number of bags per layer. Besides agricultural products such as potatoes, onions, or Brussels sprouts, the Help to Palletize unit can also process non-agricultural products such as playground sand and ornamental gravel. Seabird Head, the London and Warsaw-based brand and packaging design consultancy, has designed new PET bottle structures for PepsiCo Tropicana's launch this month of the new Still Lemonade Drinks product range. The 900 and 300ml PET bottles were structurally designed by Seabird Head to have a distinctive Tropicana brand ownable shape, create good size impression, clear standout and recognition in a cluttered chilled drink cabinet market. The UK's leading brewer of premium bottled ales, Marston's, has introduced smaller bottle sizes as it seems to satisfy consumers' growing love affair with the high-quality bottled ales. Recently published research from the brewer confirms the continued premiumisation of the ale market, with 135,000 new shoppers recruited to the sector last year. The company has launched two new 330ml glass bottles designed and made by OI,
who always remind me of that Earth, Wind & Fire song.
Oh, wow, love was a...
After pilot testing SmartStack, developed by Loadhog of Sheffield, one of Australia's largest glass manufacturers has specified the revolutionary and patented glass bottle transporting system as the standard method of conveying containers between its Australian and New Zealand operations. SmartStack system comprises the SmartPad, an injection-molded, waved, edged, layered pad, and a spring-loaded SmartFrame, which work together to prevent the collapse of bottle packs during transportation and storage. FKUR has launched a new transparent, flexible biopolymer. Called BioFlex F2201CL, this material contains a high content of renewable resources and, in line with the other resins in the BioFlex family, can be processed easily on standard LDPE blown film lines and converting equipment. With a renewable resource content of approximately 60%, this grade is a consistent further development of the BioFlex family. The third black box in Iggesen Paperboard's International Design Challenge is being presented in mid-March at an event at the Stationers Hall in London. The task was to produce an interesting design that was a challenge not only for the designer, but also for Iggesen's flagship product, Invercot. Andrea Brunazzi's solution is a survival kit for pasta lovers. The complete ready meal is packed in bioplastic-coated Invercot Bio, and the packaging ultimately functions as a pasta strainer. Now, I don't reckon these really look like this, but RPC Containers Corby has launched the Uncan, an enhanced range of retortable barrier jars for catering applications that represents an ideal mix of food-safe, long-life, lightweight jars with significant large-format cost savings. The creation of the Uncan builds upon several recent high-profile launches from the site into the retail market, including the Heinz Fridge Pack and plastic jars for Marks & Spencer's British Groceries range. BASF's biodegradable plastic EcoVio FS film is being used in a pilot project by the Waste Management Service AWB in the district of Bad Dürkheim, Germany. Starting on the 6th of April, a 3-month test will be conducted to determine whether the bags are suitable for collecting organic waste and how these bags behave on a large scale at an organic composting plant in Grünstadt. And just a little extra one for you, PepsiCo has announced that it's developed the world's first PET plastic bottle made entirely from plant-based, fully renewable resources. PepsiCo's green bottle is made from bio-based raw materials including switchgrass, pine bark, and corn husks.